Welcome back to our podcast, where we dive deep into the teachings of Jesus Christ. Today, we'll be exploring some of the most powerful and transformative words ever spoken, the words of Jesus before he ascended into heaven. The Bible contains many accounts of Jesus' life and teachings, but some of his most profound and impactful words were spoken in the days leading up to his crucifixion and ascension. Today, we'll be exploring some of those words, their meaning, and what they mean for us as believers. The days leading up to Jesus' crucifixion and ascension were a time of great significance and urgency. Jesus knew that his time on earth was coming to an end, and he wanted to make sure that his disciples and all who would come after them understood the importance of his message. During this time, Jesus spoke some of his most profound and impactful words because he wanted to leave a lasting impression on his followers. He spoke about the kingdom of God, the need for repentance and forgiveness, and the importance of loving one another. He also gave his disciples the Great Commission to go out and make disciples of all nations, which has become a foundational mission for Christians around the world. Furthermore, Jesus' words during this time were often directed specifically at his disciples, as he knew that they would be the ones who would carry on his message after he was gone. He taught them how to pray, how to live a life that was pleasing to God, and how to serve one another. He also promised to send the Holy Spirit to guide them in their mission, which would be essential in their work of spreading the gospel to the world. Ultimately, the words that Jesus spoke in the days leading up to his crucifixion and ascension are some of the most impactful and profound because they remind us of the urgency and importance of his message. They call us to repentance, to faith in him, and to a life of service and love for others. As we reflect on these words and seek to live them out in our daily lives, we can be transformed by his love and his message of salvation. One of Jesus' most famous statements before his ascension was the Great Commission, as mentioned earlier. It is recorded in Matthew 28 verses 18 to 20, where Jesus says, "All authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Therefore go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey everything I have commanded you. And surely I am with you always, to the very end of the age." This statement is significant because it outlines the mission and purpose of the church. Jesus entrusted his disciples, and all who would come after them, with the task of spreading the gospel message to all people, baptizing them, and teaching them to obey everything that Jesus had commanded. This mission is still relevant to us today as Christians, and we are called to participate in this mission by sharing the message of Jesus with those around us. Another impactful statement that Jesus made was during the Last Supper when he said, "Love one another. As I have loved you, so you must love one another. By this, everyone will know that you are my disciples if you love one another," John 13 verses 34 to 35. This statement emphasizes the importance of love and unity among Jesus' followers. Jesus wanted his disciples to love one another in the same way that he had loved them, which was sacrificially and unconditionally. He knew that this kind of love would be a powerful witness to the world, and that through it, people would come to know him and his message. Through our love for one another as followers of Jesus, we can be a powerful witness to the world of his message of love and salvation. When we love one another with the same sacrificial and unconditional love that Jesus showed us, we demonstrate the reality of our faith and the transformative power of his message. In John 13 verse 35, Jesus says, "By this, everyone will know that you are my disciples if you love one another." This means that our love for one another is a defining characteristic of our identity as followers of Jesus. It is through our love for one another that we demonstrate to the world that we are truly his disciples. Furthermore, in 1 John 4 verses 7-8, it says, "Dear friends, let us love one another, for love comes from God. Everyone who loves has been born of God and knows God. Whoever does not love does not know God, because God is love." This passage emphasizes the importance of love in our lives and reminds us that God is the source of love. As we love one another, we are reflecting the love of God to the world and fulfilling our purpose as his followers. So, as we seek to follow Jesus and his message, let us remember the importance of love in our lives and in our relationships with one another. Let us love one another sacrificially and unconditionally, just as Jesus loved us. In doing so, we can be a powerful witness to the world and bring glory to His name. Let's start with one of the most well-known and powerful statements Jesus ever made, found in John 14 verse 6. Jesus said, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." What does this mean for us as believers? It means that Jesus is not just a good teacher or a moral example, He is the only way to salvation and eternal life. He is the truth, the embodiment of everything that is good and pure in this world. And He is the life, the source of all love, hope, and joy. By believing in Him, we have access to the Father and can experience a relationship with Him that lasts for eternity. Another important statement that Jesus made before His ascension is found in Matthew 22 verses 37 to 39. He said, "You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your mind. This is the first and great commandment. And the second is like it, you shall love your neighbor as yourself." This commandment reminds us that our faith is not just about believing in Jesus and going to heaven, it's also about loving God and loving others. Jesus calls us to love God with all of our being, not just with our words, but with our actions and our thoughts. And He calls us to love our neighbor as ourselves, to treat others with the same kindness, compassion, and respect that we would want for ourselves. Finally, let's look at the Great Commission, found in Matthew 28 verses 18 to 20. Jesus said, "All authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Therefore, go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey everything I have commanded you. And surely I am with you always, to the very end of the age." This commandment is not just for the disciples who were with Jesus at the time, it's for all of us who believe in Him. Jesus calls us to go and make disciples of all nations, to share the good news of salvation with everyone we meet. He reminds us that we are not alone in this mission, He is with us always, guiding us and empowering us to do His will. In Matthew 22 verses 37 to 39, Jesus says, "Love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your mind. This is the first and greatest commandment. And the second is like it, love your neighbor as yourself." This commandment is at the heart of what it means to follow Jesus. Loving God and loving others should be our primary focus in life. Another important message from Jesus is found in Matthew 28 verses 19 to 20, where Jesus tells His disciples to go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey everything He has commanded. This is known as the Great Commission, and it is a call for all Christians to share the message of Jesus with the world. In John 14 verse 6, Jesus says, "I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." This statement underscores the exclusivity of Jesus as the only way to God. It is a central tenet of the Christian faith and a reminder of the importance of putting our faith in Jesus alone for salvation. In John 13 verses 34 to 35, Jesus says, "A new command I give you, love one another. As I have loved you, so you must love one another. By this everyone will know that you are my disciples if you love one another." This commandment emphasizes the importance of showing love to others as a sign of our faith in Jesus. Finally, in Luke 23 verse 34, as Jesus is dying on the cross, He prays, "Father, forgive them, for they do not know what they are doing." This powerful statement of forgiveness from Jesus reminds us of the great love and mercy that He showed to us by dying on the cross for our sins. It is a call for us to extend that same forgiveness and love to others in our own lives. As we reflect on these powerful statements from Jesus, let us be inspired to follow Him more closely and to share His message with others. Let us seek to love God and others, to make disciples of all nations, to put our faith in Jesus alone, to show love to one another, and to extend forgiveness and mercy to those around us. These are just a few of the many powerful words that Jesus spoke before He ascended into heaven. As we reflect on these words and apply them to our lives, may we be transformed by His love and grace, and may we be empowered to live a life that honors Him. Keep in mind that the words that Jesus spoke before His ascension are some of the most powerful and impactful in all of Scripture. They remind us of the urgency and importance of His message, the mission and purpose of the Church, and the importance of love and unity among His followers. As we reflect on these words and seek to live them out in our daily lives, we can be transformed by His love and His message of salvation. May we be reminded that the words of Jesus are not just empty rhetoric, but they are the very words of life that lead us to salvation and eternal life. As we read and study the Bible, let us always keep in mind the words of Jesus and apply them to our daily lives. Let us take these words to heart and make them the foundation of our lives, and may they guide us in all that we do. Let us love God with all our heart, soul, and mind, and let us love others as ourselves. Let us go and make disciples of all nations, teaching them to obey everything that Jesus has commanded us. Let us remember that Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life, and that no one comes to the Father except through Him. Let us show love to one another as Jesus has loved us, and may we extend forgiveness and mercy to those around us. So, let us take up the challenge of living out the words of Jesus in our daily lives. Let us be His disciples and follow Him wherever He leads us. And may we share His message of hope and salvation with those around us, so that they too may come to know the saving power of Jesus Christ.